The French Riviera has made a reputation for being the favorite playground for the rich and famous. For over a century, it was the go-to destination for Russian and British aristocrats. It has also inspired artists like Pablo Picasso and Henri Matisse. Today, it remains highly associated with celebrities and wealthy personalities. From the prestigious film festival in Cannes to Leo's yacht vacations in Saint-Tropez, the French Riviera is almost synonymous with glamour and luxury. But is it possible to explore the region on a budget? Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Yosh. Planning to go on an escapade to Nice, France? It's your lucky day because in this video, we'll break down how to do just that without breaking the bank. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. And I'm not a French speaker, and I feel like I'm about to murder pronunciation, so I'm asking you in advance to please excuse my French. Understanding Nice and the French Riviera. The French Riviera refers to the coast of Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur, the region of France tucked in the southeast corner, facing the Mediterranean Sea. Its shoreline is dotted with several picturesque cities and small towns, all easily accessible from each other, including Nice, Villefranche-sur-Mer, Antibes, Cannes, Saint-Tropez, and the Principality of Monaco, which is a completely separate country. The most ideal base in the region is Nice, dubbed the jewel of the French Riviera. From here, most of the area is easily accessible. Although Nice is the second most visited city in France today, next only to Paris, it wasn't always French. It was the Greeks of Marseille who founded the city of Nicaea in 350 BCE. It was named after Nike. Not this Nike, but this Nike, the Greek goddess of victory. But for many centuries, it was part of the Duchy of Savoy. Nice's location and history explain why a strong Italian influence is undeniable in the city today. Ventimiglia, the closest Italian city, is less than an hour away. For a time, it was also under the Kingdom of Piedmont-Sardinia until it rejoined France in 1860. So yep, Nice has only been a part of France for around 150 years. French is the language that is most widely used here. But before re-annexation by France, Nice spoke Nisar, a dialect of the Occitan language not commonly spoken today. But you can easily get by using English. Here are more bits of information about Nice. France is part of the Schengen Agreement, so a Schengen visa is required for most nationalities. If you're a Philippine passport holder, we have a separate video discussing the visa application process in detail. You may also head over to our website, www.theportraveler.net, for a comprehensive step-by-step visa application guide, or just follow the links in the description. Where to stay in Nice? Nice's city center is composed of several districts, but these three will interest tourists the most. The Old Town is the historical and cultural core of the city. Its narrow medieval alleys are lined with old buildings and punctuated by local restaurants. Its southern edge is hemmed by Promenade des Anglais, or Walkway of the English. The area also harbors several relatively cheap hostels and apartments. Jean Medsang generally refers to Avenue Jean Medsang, but in this video, let's also use it for the area surrounding it. The avenue runs from the railway station to Place Masséna at the entrance to the Old Town. The T1 tram line runs the entire length of the avenue, which means staying near it gives you easy access to other parts of the city. Another favorite among backpackers is Thiers, the neighborhood west of Jean Medsang. On our visit, we were able to book the last room at Antares Hostel, which is near the train station and just a block away from Avenue Jean Medsang. Nice and the French Riviera are served primarily by Nice Côte d'Azur Airport, often shortened to Nice Airport. Welcoming almost 14 million passengers per year, it is the third busiest airport in France, next only to Paris Charles de Gaulle and Orly. Nice Airport is used by over 60 airlines, connecting the region to numerous European cities and a few outside the continent. It is located roughly 6 kilometers from the city center of Nice, around 20 minutes away. Most online sources suggest taking Bus 98 or Bus 99 to the city center, but they are no longer operational. Instead, the newly opened Tramline 2 or T2 links the airport to the city center. Both Terminal 1 and Terminal 2 have tram stops on this line.
So, paano makapunta from airport to city center is by tram.
If your hotel is in the old town, Jean Mensong, or in the area near the Niceville station, you can easily reach any of those places by tram. First, you need to buy a ticket from the machines at the station. One-way fare is only 1.5 euro. The machine accepts euro coins and credit card only. No change given, so if you're paying cash, make sure you have the exact amount. Then, take the tram to Jean Mensong. It operates from 5:19 a.m. to 12:15 a.m. the next day. Note that there are fewer journeys in the early morning and late night. Don't forget to validate your ticket upon boarding. The validation machines are positioned by the door of the vehicle. Insert your ticket with the arrow down into the small box and wait for it to stamp your card. Get off at Jean Mensong stop. From here, make your way to your hotel. Depending on your hotel's address, you can either transfer to Tramline 1 or just walk if it's not too far. If you're coming from another European city, you can reach Nice by train or bus. Gare de Niceville is the main railway station. It's located in the Thiers area, just a short walk from the northern end of Avenue Jean Mensong. Here are the train companies operating here and the cities they connect Nice to. If you prefer the bus, Flixbus also has trips to Nice from various cities in Europe, including Milan, Genoa, Aix-en-Provence, Marseille, and even as far as Paris and Barcelona. The best way to get around Nice is by walking. The city is pretty pedestrian-friendly, and most of the key attractions are within spitting distance of each other. But if you can't travel on foot for whatever reason, you can take the public transportation too. The two primary modes here are the tram and the bus, operated by these two companies. But because their routes often overlap within Nice, their ticket systems are integrated. Fare is only 1.5 euro, valid for both the tram and the bus regardless of the distance. However, the ticket is valid only for 74 minutes. You are allowed to make a transfer as long as it's within the 74-minute period. Aside from solo tickets, you can also purchase a bus and tram pass, which comes in these three variants. These passes are also accepted by the TAM but only within the common ticket zone, which covers mostly Nice and up to Monaco. When traveling beyond this area, you will need to buy another ticket even if you have a pass. You can also get around by bike or by hop-on, hop-off bus. When is the best time to visit? Spring or autumn? Nice has a mild climate that is sunny for most of the year. However, it can get really crowded and hot during the peak summer months of July and August. The ideal seasons to visit the city are during autumn and spring, with the weather just a right mix of comfortable and sunny. French food is globally celebrated. That alone is reason enough to stuff your face with it in Nice. But there's one more reason. Niçoise cuisine is distinct, utilizing the fresh ingredients readily available in the region with a dash of Italian influence. Some of the dishes you shouldn't miss are Niçoise salad, composed of a mix of fresh and young greens like arugula, and black olives, tuna, anchovies, hard-boiled eggs and olive oil, and ratatouille, which is a layered stew of vegetables like zucchini and eggplant, which actually originated in Nice. When choosing a place to eat, look for this sign. This label is awarded to restaurants that serve quality Niçoise specialties and provide warm service. Oh, don't forget to treat yourself to a scoop or two of refreshing ice cream, especially if you're visiting in summer. Try special regional flavors like lavender, thyme, black olive, and tomato. If you want to learn more about each dish, how they are prepared, where they originated, and more, join a guided food tour. What are the attractions waiting for you in Nice? We'll be creating a separate video listing down the best places to visit and things to do in the city, so watch out for the part 2 of this video. If you don't want to miss it, subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so you're notified when it's up. If you have questions, sound off in the comment section below. If you need more information about traveling around Nice, you'll find a comprehensive travel guide with a sample itinerary on our website, www.thepoortraveler.net, or check out the link in the description. You can also follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoortraveler_L. You may also tune in to the Poor Traveler podcast on Spotify. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.